We're live at Threat Stadium here in New York, New York, the home of the Tyrants, who would like to remind you that the game will begin after the mandatory half an hour clapping is over. The first one to stop clapping will be killed. Pain, suffering, humiliation, and possibly a conga line. This game's gonna have it all. The Motor City Maniacs battle the New York Tyrants. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. It's game day here on the MFL Network, and we are just about to get underway. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow, along with Brickhead Mulligan.
Hi.
Any thoughts on today's game?
No, not really. Kind of flatlining right now in the thoughts department. Hey, can you help me get this pencil out of my ear? It's stuck worse than it was the last time.
Yeah, you idiot. And it's first and 10. The defender says, I don't think so. Second down and 10. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. And it's first and 10. And that's a work beat, and he runs it in for the touchdown. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! Talk about a guy's career blowing up.
Okay, that guy's career just blew up. Along with most of his skeleton.
He was being rhetorical, you moron.
You don't think I don't know what rhetorical is, huh? Well, I do. So please tell me.
And it's first and 10. Was an all-pro NFL hit.
Oh, seriously, man, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? You get my grill, I'll ruin your world. Ruin it.
And it's first and 10. Oh. First down and less than a defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. And it's first and 10. And an 8-yard gain on that one.
Like when Brix's mom decided to move back in with us.
Second down and 2. Oh, man. Brix, you gotta love a player who goes down fighting. Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
And it's first and 10. Picks up maybe 4 on that play. Second down and 6. Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard?
Third and 2. Football. First down.
A man from prison just came out of the field.
It's the ref, idiot.
Oh.
Let's see what the penalty is. And it's first and 10. That's a 6-yard gain. And that'll be second down and 4. I don't know whose eyes the QB is using. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and 10. Like he just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? That line ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Brix. Second down and 10. And it's first and 10. Yeah. punishing the defenders. That's a first down. And it's first and 10. Second down and 5. Great play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a place to feel feelings. This is fun. And he shoveled his feet so well on that play. Oh, and the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. The offense lost another running back and only two remain on their roster. When a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
Yeah, like if I rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
First down and 6. It's anyone's game at the end of quarter one. Second down and more than the QB would like. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And that'll bring up third and 1. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey. And coach isn't liking that call. Oh, his head just exploded.
Gladness. Ah, oh, shit.
Third down and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. Third down and the offense needs a miracle. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. The offense is down to their last running back. If they lose him, they lose all their running plays. This is going to be a long kick. Let's see if he can make it. Straight through the uprights. Looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and 10. And the passing. Oh, come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so are the fans. Second and 3. Not much there, maybe a yard. Third and 2. Remember, folks, in the MFL, you are allowed to touch the quarterback, just like that. Well, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
I had a dog thing stands.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have.
Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
It's first and ten.
Come on, hit me, shot.
And he fumbles it, Bricks. That was a screwed up play if I ever saw one. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. The 10. Here comes the defense. For the extra point. Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. My turn on the line.
Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckle.
And it's your mother over top of the chainsaw. He's in front of him. He's at the 40. The 30. The 20. He's at the 10. Touchdown! And dances just like my mother-in-law.
Maybe it is your mother-in-law, if I'm not mistaken.
You know what? You're right.
They're going for 2 points. QB know which team he's on?
I don't even know where I'm at.
No, oh, with the brain scrambler. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
And it's first and ten. You know, a lot of guys talk about stepping up their game, Bricks. He just stepped up and blew up. He's got a lot of guts, doesn't he? And you can see the grounds crew cleaning him up now. Hot potato gets him every time. And it's first and ten. That's a pass and catch for no gain.
Then how is it a pass?
Second down and ten.
Playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
It might make more sense to punt here than attempt a field goal. This is way too long. We're at the 2-minute warning, and we'll take a quick timeout.
Graham, will you tell the interns to get us some Franken dogs and a couple of beers? I'm dry over here.
I'll take nachos and a scotch. Wish they could pee for me, too.
You can tell he's a berserker because he's dropping at the mouth.
Oh!
Well, surprise me. He made it look easy, and he gets 3 points for it. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. And it's first and 10. And the defense spiked the offensive water with Strawberry Fields. And now they can taste sound, but can't remember. He's not going down. Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first time out.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
Second down in a very lot.
Sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him.
The QB saved some clock by calling a timeout. They have one left. And it's first and 10. Boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger because he's going to kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message. Because the messenger killed him. Ah, I'm going in circles.
When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. And another... Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And it's first and 10. He's got a receiver breaking open. And that's another pick. Man, oh man, the defense is going to have more. He is fighting for a man. What a hit that was. And the offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brent's match stupsing time.
That's why the girls call.
The quarterback unleashes a spiraling. And he's running like a... Oh, a great catch. And he picks up a new set of downs. First and 4. And he takes a timeout here. They have 2 left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just going to take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play.
They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up, too?
Oh, great throw! Great catch! And then put 6 points on the board!
The defense can do anything to stop a throw that good, Grim!
You mean aside from priming the ref, killing the quarterback, or actually playing some D?
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
He just got crushed. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. Welcome back. Hope you enjoyed the carnage during today's halftime show. Obviously, they need to play a lot harder here in the second half to make a game of it.
Or they could start cheating and killing. That's what I'd do.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Oh, man, he really wants it.
And he's off to the races. And it's first and 10. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. And it's first and 10.
In the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have been
boom.
First and 10. Defense holds him to a 4-yard pickup there. Second down and 6. And he was stuck to him like glue. Third down and 6. One potato, two potato, three potato, four. The defense just... And the offense has only two running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last two runners for this outman.
And it's first and 10. And he gets his bell rung for a yard. Second down and 9. At this point with multiple interceptions.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome! I hope they have raincoats in the front row because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's first and 10. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and 10. Touchdown on that deflection. Second down and 10. dropped him. I gotta see. You gotta be fucking kidding me. If that's a penalty, they should come up here and penalize us too.
Hey, don't give these refs any ideas, you idiot. Brim, hide the stash.
On it. Second down, the defense had enough with this rep and jumps offside to kill him. First down and seven. Quarterback throws another pick.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and ten.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
And the defense recovered. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim. But my watch is a bit slow.
Hell no, son of a. And it's first and ten.
You can't keep a good meal.
He caught him, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Man, are these guys greedy or desperate? Either way, they're going for two. They need a good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grant. You're right.
He was starting to go somewhere, but he gets stumped after three.
They usually stop. After three, too. You know, the all-you-can-eat buffets? They're not as literal as you'd think.
Second down and seven. Fumble! You gotta protect the ball better than that. Oh, man, Bricks, you gotta love a player who goes down fighting. The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass. Right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. Third and two. Man, he's running like a bull on steroids. That'll be a first down. And it's first and ten. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
The offense lost their final running back. Lucky for them, they're on defense now.
They're lucky to have survived so much bad luck, carnage, and death, Grim.
And it's first and ten. First and four. And he zips that one in there for a touchdown. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's first and 10. First and 10. Second down and long. QB looks angry at his offensive line, and I can't blame him. Third down, and the QB is saying his prayers. That ball was almost intercepted. The teams have kept each other at bay for now, but there's still plenty of time to bribe refs and kill the other team's star players, so it's anyone's game, really, Bricks. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he put all of his foot into that one. Nice catch, and he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
It's first and 10. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. And it's first and 10. For a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's first and 10. Oh, the Strawberry Fields dirty trick. And there's another pick. Man, this quarterback must have learned a lot about sharing when he was in school.
Yeah, that's right.
Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich?
Prison just came onto the field.
That's the ref, you idiot. Let's see what the penalty is. And it's first and 10. Just bury himself now because this guy.
I've had it. I'm running out of excuses for this QB.
You just. And like bricks his balls, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
No, still working on my salami here, Bricks. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. It's first and 10.
Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. Well, that was a good throw.
Yeah, if he was aiming for the ground.
Third down and never gonna happen. Oh, the defender almost picked off the ball on that one. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Man, what a hit that was. And it's first and ten.
It's a zap attack. It's like when you...
There's no reason to drop the ball if you're still alive. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. He's at the 20. And he put the jets on and caught him from behind. First and eight to go. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and ten. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. He could go all the way. He's hit, and the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And it's first and ten. Kaboom! And he just nailed him right on the numbers for a touchdown. You know, the league used to flag this for excessive celebration. You know, refs really don't want to get too close to the rabid roided-out mobsters. And don't even get me started on the werewolves. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. It's first and ten. Oh, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
second down and 10. At this rate, the QB's going to have more interceptions than completions. Oh, what a brutal hit. Oh, holy smokes. He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the MFL. First and four. And that was a perfect pass, and he scores handily. You know, you have to wonder if the original creators of the Doomsday AI programmed them to dance as a way to mock us as they took over, or if they taught themselves in the irradiated ruins of the old world. Either way, enjoy. Well, why go for one when you could go for two?
It's always been my philosophy, but bricks can't even get one. Oh, you're talking about points.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? The burn returner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. And it's first and 10. The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have two left. Second down and a lot. And that's the kind of play you pay the secondary for.
You pay him for the pick six. For this, you just give him a pat on the head and tell him they don't suck.
Third down and, well, good luck. At this point, with multiple interceptions, the QB should just throw in the towel.
Yeah.
He broke free and has open field in front of him.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see it. You're too fast.
And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10. Cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. Oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. He could go all the... never mind. I don't remember that being an officially sanctioned MFL rule. It's a jailbreak, and the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Ho-ho! Crowds love it.
This is what you got to do.
lost another linebacker on that play, and only two remain on their roster. Their defense is getting very close to forfeiting this game. The offense is down to their final lineman, so he'll be playing center for the rest of the game.
How's he going to be able to block all those defenders by himself, Grim?
Well, he can't, which is why the QB is going to have to get rid of the ball very, very fast if he wants to stay alive. The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. And he was steering a pick six but dropped the interception.
And that's why he's on defense, schmuck.
And the offense goes into a hurry-up to pick up the pace of the game. And that's perfect coverage. Nice deflection. The Tyrants are defeated and walk away losers. They battled hard but still got their butts handed to them.
Gross. I hope there weren't any orc butts involved.
I kind of like orc butts, especially with some Dijon mustard and a smoked pickle relish. Now that's living.
Let's go down to the field and see what the game's MVP thinks of today's outcome. Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by the Hexon Oil Corporation. We drill it, spill it, and kill it so you...